In just a few short hours, all the members of this chamber will be gathering across the street in the Legislative Office Building to acknowledge and celebrate some exceptional women of distinction from our own districts, as the Senate does every year when we pause to reflect upon the contributions of particular women from our own areas. They will be ordinary women. In many ways, they're family members, they're professionals, they're nurses, they're teachers, they're volunteers, all exceptional in many ways. But before we do this, I'd like to take a moment to reflect on this special day and pay tribute to the contributions that female leaders have given us throughout the years. Historically, great achievements have been made by women from every corner of New York State. Susan B. Anthony, who started as a teacher in hardscrabble New York and began her career in social activism in Rochester. Eleanor Roosevelt, born on West 37th Street in New York City, fought for civil rights during her tenure as First Lady and continues to inspire many young women till today. Ella Fitzgerald, grew up in Yonkers, became the First Lady of Jazz. Lucille Ball, from Senator Young's district, was born and raised in Chautauqua and went on to become a screen legend and a cultural icon and one of the funniest women ever to grace the small screen or the large screen. Harriet Tubman did the majority of her inspiring work in women's suffrage movement from her home in Auburn. Distinguished women from the worlds of business, academics, civil life, as well as those who have performed heroic or selfless acts, have made significant discoveries, persevered with excellence against difficult odds, have been honored at this annual event since 1998. Tonight, when we stop and we celebrate the accomplishments of these fine women, we will also pay tribute to those female leaders who came before them and look forward to the future where more women leaders will no doubt emerge. I commend all of the women who are here tonight for their public service as well as their leadership and courage, and I also commend all of my fellow female members of the New York State Senate for being exceptional women in their own right. Thank you, Madam President.